arbitrarily.
Disjunct and displaced. There is no weight on your shoulders. There is no weight at all.
Sleep Laboratory is a immersive participatory installation in which an audience in a small group is invited to compare the real and the virtual, the inside and the outside, and reality and a dreamlike state. In this installation, a group of 12 people arrives and is greeted by one person and an info monitor, and then split up into groups of two.
Person B will put on the VR glasses.
Different people in the installation hear different things and experience different things at different times. So it's also a bit the idea of then to later compare and maybe talk about how one person experienced one moment while the other one was having a different perspective on it. So this is one thing that we are doing is we are recreating a out-of-body experience where you see your body lying on the bed, and then slowly your perspective glides out of the body.
Person B on the bed will now slowly transcend out of its body. Observe your partner, the skin, the screen, you are seeing this from the outside. Hold the shoulder of the lying person. Apply soft pressure.
Follow the hand on the screen.
Reset the body.
Reset the body.
A gradual realignment.
They are also the performers. And the performers support and help the audience. That is the other level of comparison and also of virtuality and realness, if you want. So this process of this constant comparing of being inside, being outside and watching the inside of the other person through a monitor, that is basically what the piece is really about.
The theme here actually also is a little bit inside-outside with the composer and the performer, I think.
You're very close. You touch the person lying on the bed, so you play for them. So it's quite intimate.
Because when we perform normally on stage, you know, you're on stage and the audience is in the hall, so it's already a disbalance of like you're acting and they are receiving.
Sometimes you're kind of blown away by things that can happen in VR, but almost more interesting is the part when you take off the headset again and how strangely flat and blunt reality looks then.
You can take your VR glasses off now and leave the headphones on.
If you see all these kind of saturated, computer-animated people and then look in the face of an actual human being, it's a kind of re-evaluating and it's something less perfect and fragile or vulnerable in the reality, and it makes you appreciate that as something beautiful too.